Hey everybody, this is Phoenix Down, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy VI. In the last episode, while we were competing at the Dragon Neck Coliseum, we ran into Shadow and convinced him to join the effort against Kefka. So now our party is growing, we have another member in our ranks, and in between episodes, I did a little more competing at the Coliseum. I acquired some more items, I wagered some stuff I wasn't really going to use anyway, and got some better stuff in return. So let's go over a little bit of that real quick. I'll try to remember to list this in the video description. But anyway, we already saw the Minerva. I showed that one on screen. But Sabin, I got him the red jacket. It's pretty much the best piece of body armor that Sabin can equip in the game. Which is a little sad considering that other characters like the girls get Minerva and some really awesome stuff. Force armor and Genji armor, so on and so forth. But it does nullify fire damage. And it's just all around, it comes in handy. And what I had to do to get that is I had to go down to Jador, actually, and buy a sniper. It's a weapon that's it's equipped by only Locke, and it's basically an upgrade of the Hawkeye that we saw in the World of Balance. Functions the same way as that. Locke's not in the party, obviously, so I just wagered that. Got a bone club, which I then used to get the red jacket. So, I mean, I don't think we had to fight anybody really tough. I think the sniper battle was the Boris encounter that I showed on screen with Celeste last time. Anyway, I also got three more flame shields. Again, we saw that one on screen last time. But that, I don't think I went into its properties. The flame shield absorbs fire, nullifies ice, but is weak to water. So keep that in mind whenever you want to use that. And let's see, wrong button. Anyway, Shadow. Yeah, I got the Striker by competing against Shadow, and that's about it. He's also equipped with the, I got a second experience egg from fighting a Dark Force. I wagered a Tintinabar, and I got an experience egg. It was basically a fight against the Outsider that we saw with Setzer, killed it with an instant death attack before it could kill me. It took a few tries for that one, though, unfortunately. I was not lucky off-screen. Another thing, actually, now that I think about it, off-screen, while Sabin was fighting to get the, the aura I got last time, to get a Strato, Sabin actually used his Desperation Attack, the Tiger Break. Unfortunately, I was not recording it, otherwise I'd be showing that footage right now. I was really kicking myself when I saw that. I just had this feeling. It's like, ah, oh, he's gonna do his Desperation Attack, I just know it, and then he did it, and it's like, crap! Anyway, I got, for Gao, a really nice piece of body armor, the Snow Muffler. Only Gao and Mog can equip it, but it's really good. It absorbs ice, I think it nullifies fire, and it might have some other elemental properties, but its defense stat is really high, and the only way you can get it is by wagering the behemoth suits that you get over in from fighting the senior behemoth, that boss battle from last time. Well, he is now a monster you can encounter on the Veldt, so you can get behemoth suits over and over and over again if you fight on the Veldt long enough. So I'll be getting a second Snow Muffler eventually when I do that. Let's see, anything else. So I got the a Pearl Lance for Edgar and Mog when we get Mog. That's I bet that Strato I talked about last time, or earlier, and got the Pearl Lance. It's basically the second most powerful lance in the game, and it also randomly casts the Pearl spell, which is pretty handy. It really comes in handy. Let me check my notes real quick. Anything else I wagered? I bet an elixir to get a rename card from fighting against Cactrot. They're basically Cactar in more recent Final Fantasy translations. These guys, we'll encounter, I'll show them eventually, but they have almost perfect defense and magic defense. So basically any attack you do to them that actually hits them, because they're very evasive too, only does 1 HP worth of damage. They only have like 5 or 6 HP though. So what I did was, that's what I equipped Setzer with the dice for, because that does fixed damage based on the number he rolls. And every combination is higher than, you know, a single digit number, so basically, Setzer gets his turn, boom, he wins. So I got a rename card, and then I wagered that against the Doom Dragon, which is a enemy you can encounter in the final dungeon. I had Celeste with almost perfect magic block fighting against him. It took a couple tries because almost is not perfect. But he has an attack that can bring your HP down to a single digit, so I just got unlucky a few times. For doing that, though, I got the Marvel Shoes, which is a pretty nice relic that gives you auto safe, auto shell, auto regen, and auto haste. Haste. So all four of those at the same time. It's really nice, basically better than the running shoes because it gives you all sorts of status protection, or status protection too, technically. And, magic and physical defense. I think that's about everything. All right, so anyway, sorry, it took a little longer than I thought it would. So what are we going to do today? I think we should go and check out Narsh, which is over this way. Yeah, it's the place where we began the game at. I guess it's only fitting that we go and visit it eventually. Yeah, we have that frozen Asper that we've been told about. So let's go in here. So Narsh is here. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to head over to the classroom over here and use the recovery spring because I was a little low on MP. And we have our first battle against some red wolves. Okay, these guys are weak against fire, so what I'm going to do is just have Gao use the Templar. Shadow, you fight. Celeste, you do the same. Sabin, let's do a fire dance. I think I inputted that correctly. Alright, yep, I did. It's been a little while since I had to do the fire dance properly. At least it feels like it. Alright. Yeah, those guys aren't anything to sneeze at, or not really worth our time. Gao gained a level, alright. So let's head over into Narsh. Wait, what the? Oh, is that Lone Wolf? What are you doing here? Doesn't matter, really. Nothing left, anyway. There's only one Moogle still around, and only a treasure hunter could pick that lock. Huh. And then he runs off. So yeah, there's basically no reason to really explore the town itself. All the buildings are locked. The doors are locked, you can't enter. I mean, sure, you'd think Sabin could just break them down anyway, but you know, we'll have to come back into the town proper later when we have a certain treasure hunter in the group. But he did mention a Moogle was left behind. I wonder. We should probably check in on that. So let's go over to the secret passage over this way. I'm surprised no one else fought me along the way, but anyway, we opened up the passage. So let's go into the caves. There are some new enemies in these tunnels now. You notice we have the previous overworld music for this area now. Anyway, we have some new Magrotors. So those brown ones, I really want to see those guys on the Veldt eventually. Because, well, they... I'm gonna find my skeins. Because they can, there we go. They can teach Gao the level 4 flare technique, the lore, so that would be an easy way to teach that to Strago. So, alright, Shadow's gonna throw a skein at these guys. Okay, the little ones out of the way. You wanna defeat the little ones first because their attack script is kind of mixed with a different enemy AI, and when they're by themselves, they have a chance to use the fireball attack, and Sabin learned a new blitz, alright. It's been a little while since we learned a new blitz besides the bum rush, but that doesn't count level-wise. So let's take a look at that real quick. We have the air blade. So yeah, it's basically about 3/4 of all the button inputs from the bum rush. So that'll be easy to execute. But it's a multi-targeting wind elemental attack, very nice. I'll be using that soon enough. A lot of the enemies here are weak to fire. Just some more red wolves, nothing to worry about there. You can cast Vanish on your party for these outdoor segments of Narsh, because every single monster you can fight here is only physical oriented. We have another cave here. I think the enemies might change here. Yep, they changed. We got the Wizard and the Psychot. Okay, these guys can be a pain. So let's check out our new air blade attack. And so let's blast these guys with fire. Wait. I think the Psychots actually absorb fire. I'm gonna have Gao use ninja. Anyway, this is the air blade. Nice. Alright. Completely wiped him out. Alright guys, so let's move on. I don't think there are any other indoor monster encounters. I think all the other new enemies are on the outside. We don't have to worry about the security system anymore, so just a straight line will do. Yeah, eventually I will start using a party that does not have Sabin in it, but he's just so good right now, it's hard to pass him up. But yeah, that air blade just wiped out the entire group of psychots and wizards in one shot, so yeah, he's good to have right now, especially since he has two earrings equipped, boost his magic power. So we remember this place from the beginning of the game. Alright, Shadow gained a level from that one. Let's move on. Alright, Shadow learned Fire 2. One thing I forgot to mention, actually, when you have the elemental shields equipped, you actually start learning level 2 magic spells based on that element. At just like if you had an Asper equipped. So Shadow, he's got both Maduin and a Flame Shield equipped, so he just learned Fire 2 at a 5 times percent rate. He had the 3% here and a 2% for the shield. So that was pretty cool, and something I neglected to mention before, and Celeste has finished learning Siren. So let's see, anything else to learn? I guess I can give her Ifrit, why not? She could use some physical power anyway, even though magic is her specialty. All the magic boosting aspers are taken right now. Anyway, we don't have to worry about monsters here. We have the Moogle Room, and hey! I remember you! Mog? Yeah, he's a little surprised to see us. Koopapo! You're alive! I thought you were all feeding the worms, Koopo! Koopo-ho! Let's go! And he's looking us over. He's not alone anymore. But what's up with that face? Say, we could use some Sasquatch muscle. Besides, he'd be helpless here without me. He's somewhere in the mines. Once we find him, I'll order him to join us. So, a Sasquatch, huh? I guess we did have that mentioned before. You know, we had a relic that we acquired that only a Sasquatch can equip. Huh. So we can actually get a Sasquatch in the group? Well, if we go over to the spot where Mog was standing and talk to the wall, we received the Moogle Charm, a really potentially broken relic in this game. You know, only Mog can equip it, but when you have Mog equipped with it, you get no random encounters at all. You can go anywhere, and as long as it's not like a fixed encounter with like a boss or something, you don't have to worry about any kind of monsters whatsoever. And also, over here, I won't be using it too much, but it might come in handy at times. You know, you can go into like the Fanatics Tower and get all the treasure there before worrying about the dungeon and anything. But anyway, if you followed my advice and did not open this chest earlier in the game, you get a ribbon! Alright, we've got another ribbon finally! Perfect status immunity! There's two more chests in this dungeon that we have not opened yet that I'm going to get. So let's continue on. Okay, here's one of them. I believe this one is going to be an elixir. Alright. Yeah, before it was like just like a Phoenix Down or a sleeping bag or something like that. It's good to wait on some of this stuff. Yeah, the air blade is just so good. I know I said it before, but geez, man. Really helping things out. And in the final chest that we had to wait to open to get the upgraded contents for, we get a pod bracelet. I believe this gives you auto-safed and auto-shell, which is kind of redundant after getting the Marvel shoes last in between episodes. But oh well, take what you can get. And the save point isn't there anymore, but don't worry about that. So we'll just continue on. And anyway, I am going to head back over to the airship. So basically, I'm going to change up my party. I'm going to bring Mog along because we need him to acquire our Sasquatch muscle, basically. So I'm going to finish this battle off, and then I will meet you guys back inside Narsh. I'll meet you guys around, you know, that bridge where, I'll just meet you at the entrance of Narsh when I rearrange my party. So I'll see you guys in just a moment. Alright, we're back in Narsh. And I got Mog in the party now. I swapped him out with Gao because Mog can equip... Wrong character. Mog can equip the Snow Muffler. Look at his defense. He has got maximum defensive power right now. Very nice. He's going to be really resistant to physical attacks. So let's press onwards. We don't have to recover anymore. So we're going to head over to the mountains now where the Frozen Asper is. Now we have a new enemy, the Test Rider. I fought one of these guys at the Coliseum off screen, but he wasn't that tough. He has a 33% chance of counterattacking, and sometimes he does the Gold Lance attack as a counter, which can be pretty painful. But there's nothing we couldn't handle. I've got Mog equipped with the Phantom Asper, by the way, because I plan on using that in an upcoming battle. So there's one or two more monsters to find here on the outskirts, or the outdoor segments of Narsh. Anyway, Sabin gained another level there. He's at level 31. This is pretty good. I was getting a little worried about having to fly with half of my party at level 30. Anyway, okay, that brown Magrotor tried to counterattack his final move with a fireball, but Sabin absorbed that with the flame shield equipped. Yeah, the Magrotors have a random chance of dropping fire skeins, which can come in handy if you're using Shadow to throw things. I haven't done a whole lot of throwing with him, but you can if you want to. But Airblade is doing a lot of damage. If you really wanted to, you could actually come to this place before going to Mount Zozo, and you know, the enemies aren't that tough here. Although I say that now that I have the Airblade at my disposal, but you can if you want to. I mean, this way you can get the Moogle Charm, you can do some sequence breaking, get some items from dungeons with minimal risk. You can enter the final dungeon and get some of the treasures that way with just Mog walking around with the Moogle Charm. But anyway, we're here up towards the mountains. We remember this patch. Anyway, this is a battle in a snowy field. We haven't had one of these yet. So let's prepare an air blade. Hopefully I didn't accidentally hit the up key there at the wrong time. All right, here we go. We got an air blade coming. So Sabin's gonna wipe these guys out real quick. Yep, all down in one hit, all too easy. And Shadow gained a level, all right. And Mog mastered the final dance, the Snowman Jazz. I honestly don't remember the moves off the top of my head. There's a snowball attack, it does an attack called Surge. And there's two other moves, and what the? All right, well, there's a dragon roaming around. Before I go and approach him, though, I want to give Shadow a different Asper because he just mastered Maduin. So let's see, what does he need now? Something with a stat boost. I guess I'll give him Golem, why not? And let's see, I guess I'll have Celeste top everyone off. Man, Shadow's got quite a bit of HP there, man. He broke the 2000 mark after that level up. I don't think I got him equipped with anything that boosts HP. But all right, let's go and fight this dragon. Assuming he comes back over this way. Then we'll call it a day for today. Come on, come back here. And he's just going nuts. I have a special strategy in mind for this guy. The Ice Dragon. All right, with my first move, I want to cast... Let's see if Sabin has the spell in mind. Let's see, where is it? Yeah, Berserk. Because he focuses mostly on ice elemental attacks. He has Ice 3. He has Northern Cross, which can freeze you. He has Absolute Zero and the attack I mentioned before from Mog's Dance, the Surge, which I think is Earth Elemental, I'm not exactly sure. But if you cast Berserk on him, and then I'm going to wait and see if it connects first. And if that works... Alright, I'm going to have... Oh, whoops, Shadow is supposed to still have... Wait, let me get back to Mog. Mog is the one that was supposed to have a Phantom. This didn't go quite according to plan. I kind of botched this up. Mog has Phantom. Okay, my plan is still going to work. Everybody's going to be invisible and therefore untouchable. I'm going to have Celeste cast poison on the ice dragon to help speed things along. I probably don't need to go to these extensive links because I have everyone equipped with flame shields or ice shields. And Celeste has the Minerva Bustier, or just the Minerva. And wow, look at that. Savin almost hit the maximum damage level. Don't have Mog use his dance command for this battle, because a lot of the attacks are ice elemental. But yeah, the ice dragon is pretty much a joke at this point. You can pretty much do whatever you want. You know, I got him poisoned. During the Colosseum, I realized poison is actually fairly useful. Anyway, the battle has been won. We have defeated the ice dragon. Victory is ours, and what are the spoils of our victory? We got 10 magic points, and we got a force shield. All right, another magic block boosting piece of armor, and 6 dragons remain. I am going to go in a check up on that real quick. Let's see if that's better than the Aegis shield. Let's see, it's down here. Yeah, it's got a little bit better magic block than the Aegis shield, so I'm going to give that to Celeste. The actual pure defense power is a lot lower, but her magic block is like 9 points away from maximum. And I'm going to give someone else the, let's see, who would benefit most from the, I guess I'll give it to Savin. The Aegis shield, boost his magic block. Unfortunately, that will, you know, for this area, I think I'm just going to leave it at that. So anyway, guys, next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy VI, I will meet you guys at the save point. If you remember the save point from before Kefka's attack on this mountain to get the Espers before, I will meet you guys right up there. And next time we will go and check up on that frozen Asper, see if we can acquire ourselves a new piece of Magisite. And then maybe look into getting that Sasquatch muscle. So this has been Phoenix Down, and I will see you guys next time.